Please pardon my voice. I had a program last night, so that's the cost of my voice. But I'm believing God that the cost of the program is declared in the name of Jesus. I'm not Pastor Oshin, I'm just representing him. He is on our way to be absent, so he has to call me to help him to stand the gap. So I'll be taking his speech this afternoon. And I want you to go along with me as I go. I pray that the Lord of us will bless today in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, amen. Very to be and peace present here. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, honorable custodians of knowledge, legislators, mentors, and guardians, head of institutions and human rights defenders, co-speakers and discussants, honorary press promoters, future leaders of Africa, and all prestigious athletes, I say welcome to us all. Today, I will take the topic, knowledge, education, beyond the school classroom. Education beyond the school classroom. And I have three keynotes here which I'm giving out. The first one being education. The second one, trying to talk about the world beyond. And the third one is the school classroom. Now, before I proceed, it was George Washington that said, education is the key to unlock the golden door of freedom. For the benefit of those who are like me, I will repeat myself. Washington once said, George Washington, education is the key to unlock the golden door of freedom. Sidney J. Harris went to watch this war. He said the whole purpose of education is to turn mirrors into windows. I say again, the whole purpose of education is to turn mirrors into windows. As if that is not enough, Nelson Mandela went to ask him. He said, education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. And lastly on that, John Dewey said, education is not preparation for life. Education is life itself. Now, be that as it may, we cannot go ahead and define what education is. If it had to be a classroom, I would have asked the learners here, what is education? Of course, education is open-ended. It's broad. So, we're going to change my education this way. Education is the process of facilitating learning, acquisition of knowledge, skill, values, beliefs, and habits. I take it away. Education is a process of facilitating learning, acquisition of knowledge, skills, values, beliefs, and habits. It involves the development of the whole person intellectually, emotionally, socially, physically, and morally. So, are we following? Can I hear that? Are we following? Alright, we have forms of education. Education can be formal, as in you go to school, you go to college, you go to universities, it's the formal setting. Education can be informal as a learning through experience, self-study, and social interaction. And education can be non-formal as a structured learning outside the traditional classroom, such as workshops. training programs, and online classes. That is a three forms of education. So you can be formal, you can be informal, you can be non-formal. In those days, when there were no schools, our parents taught us to what we call oral conversation. They bring us outside the night, and I'm telling them, yeah, they're not. We stay up in the mango tree, we learn from there. They pass information to what we call the oral means of information. So we learn outside the school. They talk about morals. They talk about things we need to know in that. Values. We were taught to oral learning, which you call informal form of education. And as time goes on, there was development, civilization came, and we started to visit schools. People go to primary school, they go to secondary school, they go to universities, they go to college of education, and all sorts. And they get educated. So when you find yourself in school, that is a form of learning, because there's a structured part of it. There's a curriculum which you go to. So that's what we call formal education. And not formal, you bring your mind to seminars, conferences, workshops, just as we are doing today. Right now, we are not in the classroom. We are outside the classroom. But we have learned a lot from stories, from well-prepared messages. This is outside school and we are learning. So we can learn to seminars, workshops, and even learn to tourism. Socialization, when you mingle with one another, you get to learn, you get to know, you get to discover. Are we following? So whether it goes to education, cognitive development, your mind, and we need to think fast, critical thinking, solving problems. Now, we have so many problems in Nigeria today. We have problems of athletic power supply. We have problems of bad road. We have problems of leadership. So we need education. We need education to solve this problem. We have to know the genesis, the origin of the problem, and how to solve the problem. That is what education does. We also have emotional intelligence. How do you manage your anger? Anger management. How do you control yourself, your mood, your character, your behavior, your competences? It has to do with your emotion. It has to do with your emotion. The level of awareness, empathy, the social skills, the social habits, everything is under your emotional intelligence. The reason why we have violence today in homes, we call it domestic violence, is inability for the husband to manage the emotions, inability for the wife to manage the emotions and bring them out on the call about the domestic violence. Education can address this. What about socialization? Ability for you to relate to one another. There's all about self-confidence. There's all about self-esteem. If you don't have self-esteem, you have no influence. You have influence confidence. And when you have influence confidence, you don't be able to express yourself wherever you are. And that person will take time. And when you take time, that person will diminish it in terms of value. So we need education to socialize. We also need education for personal growth. Developmental values, beliefs, habits that promote individual well-being. Now, we are done with education. We are done with traditional education. We are done with social education. We are done with everything that's education, beliefs, and habits. We want to go to school, classroom. Now, as long as we need a physical, a virtual space, we are still gathered to them. Instruction. That's a class. That's grade 1 class. Grade 2 class. The Jesus 1 class. There's a 3 class. That's what we're talking about. We have a room, a confine, a space where you gather, and the teacher comes to instruct, to adjust you. That is the classroom. The classroom within the school. The place I'm not there for learning within the school. That is your classroom. And so, we have 5 methods for traditional education. When it comes to the classroom setting. One, there's a physical space. Now, this is a physical space where we come back. If there's no space, there's no room to come back. Only because it's designed, it's a matter, it's anything that operates and occupies space. So, we need a space to occupy to get the
teacher comes in. The teacher is the primary authority and the facilitator of knowledge. The teacher in your class is there to give you knowledge, to teach what you don't know. The third one is structure checking. When you arrive school in the morning, the first thing you go to your seminar, from there you go to the classroom. After the first period, you go to the next period. After the third period, you go to the next one. And you give 40 minutes for that. And the final time you go for break. After all, the teacher can take you home and mark it and assess you, give you homework, give you assignment to do. That's the structure pattern taking place in the classroom. If you get it right, you give it. If you get it wrong, this is for you. That is the structure part in the classroom. And the fourth one is formal instruction. The teacher directs, instructs, lectures, guide. He controls the classroom. He looks at the mood. He asks questions. Why are you like this? He has to look up the prevent measure to contain. He gives you instruction. Don't go like this. Write, sit, don't stay. Give your assignment, adjust. And in your words, that is instruction. Read the book, do your assignment, cross your hand, cross your feet, talk your hands. That is the assignment. And lastly, there, we have assessment and evaluation. It gives your assignment or quiz or exam, ask a question. We are done with classroom at the school, in the classroom. Are we following? You are going to say hi. Are we here? I'm going to say hi. All right. So, that is learning in the classroom. 40 minutes is not enough for you to learn everything you need to learn. 40 minutes is not enough. One eye is not enough. The other eye is not enough. So that is why learning in the classroom is not enough. It has to go beyond the classroom. Your teacher is not going home. There's something you need to do yourself. You need to go the extra mile. The teacher for 40 minutes, just a bit. But you need to read more. You want to know more. You want to read more? You want to know more? You need to read more. Now, beyond. When we talk about beyond, we say it's further away. When we talk about beyond, we need more than the normal. We mean the extra mile. We mean beyond that space. That's the meaning of beyond. Now, it was shouted as that. So you can take online course. This year alone, I have obtained 8 certificates. 8. And within online system. Both international and within the country. AI, virtual human resource, virtual digital, virtual net. Within and yet continue to work. So the same combination of work and learning. Why? Because I desire here. So, there's no excuse that because I am not in the classroom, I can not learn. No! It's a no-no. You can take all my courses. You can go to a website like Coursera, MS, and Udemy. It offers about various subjects. You can go for vocational training. Programs are focused on developing specific skills for a trade or profession. It may not happen in the classroom. Apprenticeship is there. You see a table, you see a floor, and somebody is there. He's looking for learning on the job. He is learning on the job, and he sees one time, 1 year, he has on the job, from a novice to a non. It is outside the classroom as well. So, there is no excuse for us. Now, beyond, we also have what's called experiential education. Experiential. Especially on the field, we have internship, we have volunteer work, we have travel and exploration, we have online communities, and so on and so forth. I know this young girl one day, she's an analyst at GSS 2, was asking me, Mr. Lawrence, he said, have you seen one of them before? Because it takes young girls and takes them to the UK every long holiday. A Jesus girl, taking young girls to the UK, she was asking him, "Have you seen London Bridge?" But because I am a reader, I travel through books, I'm not travel physically, but I'm trying, I'm traveling through books. I've seen Mandela, I'm not seeing face to face, but I've seen him in his life. I've seen education is beyond the classroom. Now, I want to come here. We've got time. Education is priceless. Education is priceless. It takes only those who value it to search for it, to dig to it, to discover, to acquire. If you don't desire to know, you will not know. But if you desire to know, you will know and want to know. The way man is wired, wake up man, wired, wake up wired man. A wired man will be insatiable. So, if you know something now, that thing is in the next business, then you come console it. So you want to know. When I know the point of what I came, when I came because they knew technology, but when money is okay, when other systems begin to come, it becomes console it. That is why you must not get tired in learning. That is why you must not get tired in learning. Parents and class of children think that nowadays, the generation of the students and people we have today, they don't read. If you hide treasure in books, they will not discover. They rather go to TikTok, they rather go to Facebook, and Facebook can turn away. But they cannot get knowledge. They can get knowledge. They can acquire skills. But they have to be away. They are wasting data. They are wasting time. And time is a resource. You can convert, but you cannot. You cannot revert. You can only convert. You cannot revert. So what are you doing for that? What are you doing for that? Now, I'm the other side. He said, learning is not a take by chance. So you must work it out. You must not swallow your head. You must work out. You must create time to learn. You must create time to study. You must create time to develop yourself. You must create time to develop your community power. Said, learning is not a take by chance. It will be so far without an attendant to the day. I mean, the day is so there. It is dangerous at time. If you think education is expensive, try ignorance. We walk by loss, we run by principles, we fly by instructions. Thank you.